Officer Scott, won't you join us for lunch?
No, thanks, Arix. I'm just going to grab a sandwich and get me back to work.
Very good.
The situation has reached the point where friends are accusing friends. The entire crew is on edge, myself included.
Greetings. I am the Division 14 medical specialist. Oh, it's just the way I laugh.
Wow, I never knew there were this many accidents in Starfleet.
Which is exactly why Division 14 exists. To hide the mistakes Starfleet would like to ignore.
Oh!
Portions of Daniel's body have aged at a dramatic rate. In some areas, the tissue is over 100 years old, yet other sections have been reduced to an almost fetal stage.
Work alongside a man whose body is equal parts accelerated growth and reverse aging.
But aren't there specialists who specialize in this?
Tala to Ensign Jenna, exposed to Delta radiation. Ellison Sanderson, neutrino field transporter accident.
We have two of everything.
Almost everything.
And Anthony!
Hi, Anthony.
Did it used to be a man?
Yeah, that's what we're assuming.
There are traces of human DNA. It's them.
Go lay down!
This is a normal dog, and she's messing with us.
God, not a normal dog.
Sound anymore, which was the worst part, right?
It has to be conceivable that somewhere in this galaxy there could exist creatures able to convert energy into matter.
The evacuation of the USS Rubidoux was a success thanks to the quick thinking of the Cerritos crew. While the exact classification of this space entity eludes us, we believe it to be peaceful, in search of a home.